the trash removal. My father, Paul, before he passed away, had contracted with GAD, Great American Disposal, for trash removal in the Country Village and also the Ishmaelville townhouses. GAD has supplied us with dumpsters for all of our commercial properties as well as the townhouses. The issue regarding this arose a couple weeks ago, earlier in January. I was at my mother's house, actually, and I noticed a North Country Disposal garbage truck going into our townhouse development. This was odd to me, as obviously we had a contract with GAD, and per our interpretation of the new ordinance, we were supposed to obtain our own trash collection. After discussions and several emails with Jared, it seems like the city's interpretation is that we are to be included under the city's new ordinance where North Country Disposal would pick them up. My argument to this would be, first of all, I'd like to point out that we have four buildings with four units in each building. My interpretation is that we have 16 units, not four units. Each building has the same ownership. There's four buildings there. They're all owned by Ishmael Hills Apartments LLC, all under the same management. They're all on one parcel of land, not four property parcels, and they're all covered on one property tax bill. The city attorney's interpretation is that we are four buildings with four units being used separately from each other. The next point is the dumpsters are a necessity for us. Under waste management, they would not provide dumpsters for this facility. Up until this point, it has worked out okay with each tenant having their own garbage can. But as we grow, and I can see this becoming a problem. Right now we have 16 units, so there's 16 garbage cans. As we add buildings, this problem will compound. We have room for two additional buildings at the current Ishmael Hills Townhouses site, which will bring us to 24 units, which will produce 24 cans of garbage. And we have identified a 10-acre parcel. Actually, we've had it all set up to go up the street in Ishmael Hills that has a capacity of 40 additional units or 40 more garbage cans. So if you take these two apartment complexes, you have a capacity of 64 units or 64 garbage cans. As you can see, this many garbage cans in a small area could create a problem. We have had some trouble in the past with animals and things like that, raccoons. We've had a couple of bears hanging around. And when, you know, the people that have houses there, they keep their garbage in the garage, but the tenants there have to keep their garbage outside in the garbage can. So we've had some trouble with animals in the past.
January regular council meeting for to authorize the notice of intent, publication of the notice of intent, the DDA's capital improvement bond issue. The plan right now is to, this resolution would open up the advertisement, the referendum period, 45-day referendum period for a $700,000 bond, not to exceed $700,000 bond. Could be less than that. And once that referendum period closed, then you would incorporate both bonds together under one bond issue, both capital improvement bonds. The difference being how that debt service is paid. One, of course, being from the DDA revenue, and the other portion, the $700,000 less portion from the public improvement fund. Again, this bond would be to provide the match for the Great Lakes Restoration Initiative grant for $2 million for completing phase one of the Partridge Creek project.
Would it be fair to say that the merit, aside from the financial merits of this, but the merit is we're able to do this without increasing taxes?
That's correct.
You know, this is, and I think that's important with all the bond things that are going on now in our community. This is going to be repaid through tax money that we retain through our TIF district and tax dollars that have come into the city for our capital improvement fund.
And let me add to that too. This is a little bit of a sensitive subject, considering what we've gone through with rates recently, but the original plan as proposed as part of the GLRI grant application was to provide the match from USDA Rural Development funding, and that was going to be tied to the potable water improvements that were part of the project. So USDA would look very closely at the city's rates and almost certainly require that the city increase rates to pay the debt associated with their loan. So by doing it this way, the USDA funding option did not work out, was not feasible because of different requirements between USDA and the EPA, as well as for the GLRI funding. That did not work out. Turning to the Public Improvement Fund as the source of funding then would not require any further associated rate increases. It would be using, as you said, an existing revenue stream that the council has approved, authorized by charter, to levy a millage specifically for public improvement projects. So it really is probably the most appropriate source of funding for the project. And you can see the bond schedules that we've provided from the financial consultants that work with Miller Canfield, the bond council, from a public financial management group out of Ann Arbor. And it gives you the bond schedules for different terms, 10, 15, 20, and 25-year term. And this is something that doesn't need to be decided as part of this resolution. This resolution is to open up the referendum period, publicize the notice of intent to issue the bonds, but it's something to consider as part of the issue generally.
Very good. Further discussion, Councilman Tall.
I'm going to be devil's advocate for a minute. Through the grapevine, I heard that if this bond goes through, say something catastrophic happens to the home, it's being paid from taxes that are already in place and debt levied. What would happen, say we have to take and get the money that was earmarked for each one of the funds and they weren't there? What would be the final outcome? And this is all hypothetical. I don't see
it coming out. It's a really good question. Let me give you my best explanation without having that special expertise with the bond issue like our bond council would. This is a general obligation bond, meaning that the it would be paid first out of these respective funds, the DDA or the Public Improvement Fund. If those were insufficient to provide the funding to pay that debt, then it would fall to the general fund.
So
the general fund would be required to pay that debt.
If the general fund was low, there would have to be an increase at that time. I mean, it could be 25 years long.
An increase?
In a tax.
In the general fund?
To refill the general fund.
The general fund, if those DDA public improvement funds were insufficient to pay the bond, you would then be required to pay the debt out of the general fund.
Okay.
And that would
be misunderstood.
Yeah, and currently the general fund levies the maximum millage of 15, which has been rolled back. What would happen realistically is that you would have to cut other spending and be forced to pay that bond.
So
you'd be legally required to pay that bond first.
The bond isn't given the tax rate.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
And the thing to remember with this is a lot of it is going to be for infrastructure. By far, the bulk of it is going to be for infrastructure, the Partridge Creek. It's going to be for things that they're not frills. Yeah. They're not going to be
I understand that part. The Partridge Creek isn't happening. It has to be done.
Any other discussion? All right, a motion would be in order.
I make a motion to adopt a resolution authorizing notice of intent to issue capital improvement funds and declaring intent to reimburse not to exceed $700,000.
I will second.
We have a motion and support to adopt a resolution of notice of intent to issue capital improvement bonds. Any further discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passed. I expect to be told ahead of time if the main reason for the meeting has been challenged. And I'm going to meet with our city manager and our city attorney immediately after this meeting. I'm very upset. There was some discussions at local businesses about this meeting. I questioned it and I was lied to. And I will not, as long as I'm in this chair, I will not stand for this. This is not what we were elected for. We're here to represent the taxpayers of this city and do the business of this city, not be decisive and deceptive and behind the back talking. If anybody was elected and that was their intent, you better think about resigning, because I will not accept it. As I said, the meeting is going to be adjourned. I'm going to sit with the city attorney, the city manager, and discuss this action that was taken away from City Hall and see what can be done. If anybody needs to talk to me, you can feel free to contact me through the manager's office. But you will hear about the decision and the meeting that we have after this. The motion to adjourn the board. Yes. Who's going to do the let's get out of here? Oh, I'm sorry. Support. Motion and support to adjourn. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.